Hello students, good morning. Now today we are dealing with the biology new chapter, that is the first unit. We are going to start the first unit. Myself, that the chapters what I am taking, that is zoological part. So far whatever you have studied, the botany part, zoology part, that is the first unit, it may comprises the four chapters, and last unit, that is human physiology. Human physiology comprises total 7 chapters. That what we are dealing. Apart from that, even other lectures are also taking. But now, so whatever you have studied so far, the botany chapters, that is morphology of flowering plants, anatomy of flowering plants, cell cycle and cell division also you have studied, cell the unit of life you have studied. So these are the botany part that what you have observed. Now first unit we are going to start, myself Vikas Morotgi, and now in the first unit 4 chapters are there, and already some messages also sent you that some part of the topic has to be deleted. So it has been deleted, and now deleted portion only we are dealing. Don't worry about that, deleted portion only we are dealing. So in the unit 1, we are going to start the unit 1. The unit 1, diversity in living organisms. Unit 1, diversity in living organisms. It comprises mainly 4 chapters. Number 1, living world. Number 2, biological classification. Number 3, plant kingdom. Number 4, animal kingdom. So as far as your syllabus part is considered, diversity in living organisms. So various organisms are existing on the earth in a different ecosystem, that what you have already studied. Some of them are present in the desert area, some of them are present in the grassland, some of them are present in the aquatic region. So different regions, variety of organisms are existing. That is what we are observing, that diversity of living organisms. And first chapter is the living world. Introduction I am giving now. In the living world, we are studying general characteristics of living and non-living things. So how do you say that it is living? Those characters we are studying. Apart from that, how the classification has been made, and then as far as your part is concerned, taxonomy part is also there. Various classification like phylum, class, family and all those things. But earlier it was there. Now from your portion it has been deleted. Only limited portion is left in the living world. That one only we are dealing. That much you are going to study. From this chapter usually they are going to ask about 3 marks. 3 mark question is going to be asked. So now next is the biological classification. In the biological classification, we are observing about the kingdom, monera, protista and fungi. This chapter is normally important in the NEET examination also. That is why portion has not been deleted. So this is any content whatever is there in the biological classification, it has been kept as it is. So biological classification comprises kingdoms, monera, protista and the mycota. Mycota andre fungi. Next is only that one we are going to be observing the biological classification. Plant kingdom, you might be studied in the 10th standard or 9th standard also. Plant kingdom, in the plant kingdom also you are going to study about that remaining part. After mycota, total 5 kingdom system of classification is there. So here 3 kingdom already we have studied in the biological classification, and plant kingdom you are studying the only the last whatever we are observing the plant kingdom, kingdom plantae, these are sub, because small monera, what kind of organisms are existing? Only the bacteria or blue green algae. And now protista, single celled organisms, mycota, multicellular, you know that. But here plant kingdom and animal kingdom, why they kept separately means enormous amount of the plant species are there. The divisions are also there. That is why they kept separately. Plant kingdom is there, and in this plant kingdom we are studying about right from multicellular algae. Shaivalagula anta karithuvu multicellular algae, that what we are studying. Sasya samrajya mattu prani samrajya. So in the plant kingdom we are studying about that right from algae. Algae, bryophytes, haavasya sasyagalu anta karithuvu, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms. Gymnosperm. ಈಗ ಅನಾವೃತ ಬೀಜ ಸಸ್ಯಗಳು, ಆವೃತ ಬೀಜ ಸಸ್ಯಗಳು ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಕನ್ನಡ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಓದಿರಬಹುದು, ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಹೌದಾ? ಕನ್ನಡ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ ಬುಕ್ ಇತ್ತಂದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಯು ಕಮ್ ಟು ನೋ ದಟ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್. ಜನರಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಬುಕ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಕನ್ನಡ ಬುಕ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ನೋಡಬಹುದು, ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್. ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಶೈವಲ್ಗಳು, ಆಲ್ಗೆ, ಬ್ರಯೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್, ಹಾವಸ್ಯ ಸಸ್ಯಗಳು, ಇದರದ ಜನರಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಪ್ರಮುಖ ಗುಣಲಕ್ಷಣಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ಗೆ, ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಬ್ರಯೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್, ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟ್ಸ್, ಜಿಮ್ನೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್, ಎಂಜಿಯೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್. ಬಟ್ ನೌ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ಗೆ, ಬ್ರಯೋಫೈಟ್, ಟೆರಡೋಫೈಟ್, ಜಿಮ್ನೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ಸ್. Angiosperm portion is deleted because this already you have studied in the morphology of flowering plant. That is why angiosperm part is over. Even reproduction is also there. Fertilization, how it is taking place in the angiosperm, this you are studying in the second year also. So that is why plant kingdom nalli ee portion matra ottu, right? Animal kingdom, in the animal kingdom you can observe that here portion is not deleted. So animal kingdom it comprises mainly the both invertebrate and vertebrate species, athava chordates and non chordate species. Kasherukagalu mattu akasherukalanna complete agi study madutha in the animal kingdom we are studying. So in this way whatever the deleted portion is there, that we are not dealing here. Remaining part ಎಷ್ಟು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್, ಅಷ್ಟು ಪೈಲಾ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡಿ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಟುಡೇ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ವೆರಿ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್, ಸಮ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡಿಲೀಟೆಡ್. ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್. ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್. ಅಂಡ್ ನೌ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್, ಜೀವ ಜಗತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಅನ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್, ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಸೇ ದಟ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್? ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್, ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್, ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಡ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ, ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್, ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್. ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. How do you say that the living organism is said to be living means all these characters are there? ಈಗ ಒಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಇದ್ದಾನ ಅಂತಂದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ನು ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೀರಿ? ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಇದೆ, ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಇದೆ, ಹೌದಾ, ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಆನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಪ್ರಚೋದನೆ ಮತ್ತು ಪ್ರತಿಕ್ರಿಯೆ, ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಯಾರ ಹತ್ರ ಇರ್ತವೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಗುಣಲಕ್ಷಣಗಳು ಯಾರ ಬಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತವೆ ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಸೇ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್? ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್, ದೆನ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಚರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೇ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್, ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್, ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್, ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ living organisms, characteristics of living organisms. We have to write first here characteristics of living organisms, characteristics of living organisms. As already I told you that diversity in the living organisms अथवा लिविंग वर्ल्ड वेरायटी ऑफ ऑर्गनिजम्स विच आर एक्सिस्टिंग ऑन द अर्थ इन डिफरेंट लोकेशंस बेरे बेरे लोकेशन ऑर्गनिजम I'm not saying that the organism only present on the air, the organism which are present only in the water, various locations are there. That is called as an ecosystem. Pond ecosystem, what we are observing that, forest ecosystem, we are saying that. So, variety of organisms are existing on the earth, that is what we are observing the world diversity. And now, here we are studying the characteristics of living organisms. One thing you have to remember that, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಜೀವಿಗಳ ಪ್ರಮುಖ ಗುಣಲಕ್ಷಣಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಅದರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಎಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ನಾರ್ಮ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಂಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ನಾನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಬರೇ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಂಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ನಾನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ನೌ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಆಸ್ ಪರ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ನೋ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ಇರ್ತವೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್ This is acceptable. So now, characteristics of living organisms, we are observing that the first one is the growth. Whether growth is taking place in all living organisms, yes. Without growth, it is not possible. So growth is taking place in the plants, yes. Growth also takes place in the plants. Growth also takes place in the animals. So, what we are observing that, whether growth is existing in all living organisms, okay, this is the correct answer that living organisms shows. Definitely this character, growth, right? So here, how the growth is taking place, we'll observe here. Only limited part we are studying about this. Before studying all those things, first we are observing about the definition of the growth. What do you mean by the term growth? Growth is the definition I am telling you that it is the irreversible permanent change of an organism. It is an irreversible permanent change of an organism. Irreversible permanent change of an organism means irreversible. As the definition says, irreversible, no reverse. Once a growth aayitu andre matte growth kadime agodilla. So this is irreversible permanent change of an organism, right? So now growth is an irreversible permanent change of an organism. Next is how the growth is taking place. We are studying only the living concept. Living being nalli growth enga aguthade. Take your own example how the growth is taking place. So now growth agbekadre eradu point important irutu. Two points you have to remember that growth is nothing but increase the body mass. And increase the mass, athava mass antanabodu, increase the mass and number. Because when we are comparing with the non-living object, here we have to observe regarding the mass. Increase the mass and the number. This is the growth. Increase the mass and the number. So here, how do you say that they increase the mass? How the growth is taking place in the living organisms? Living organisms only growth yavatara aagtade. How it is taking place? Take the example of small baby. Just born baby to the 2 month baby. 2 month baby to the 2 years baby. Like that. So, how it is taking place, how the growth occurs, here you have to identify the height of the person, height of the organism. Il height andre enu growth. Growth avakadre mass increase aagtade. A mass increase avakadre main karana enandre cell division. As already you have studied cell division. So cell division takes place an important role for the growth. Cell division takes place an important role for the growth. This is a very important part. Then how the cell division takes place, you know that. This is inside the body. All living organisms grow because of the cell division. Cell division is taking place inside the body. Mass adare horagade alla. Inside the body itself, normally the development which is taking place as the number of tissues and the cells are the whatever it is, even cell division takes place, then what will happen here? Increase in the body mass. When the body mass is going to be increased, then automatically what will happen here? Growth occurs. Hanging olagade cell division aagutha hogutade, growth aagutha. Idu one point, this is considered as one point. So if you do word, these are the twin characteristics of growth. One, though, increase the mass and the number. Increase the mass and the number. If increase the mass is over, number, how it is taking place? Increase the mass and the number, and take the unicellular organisms. Increase the mass, and the division of the cell takes place. Continuously, cell has to divide. That is correct. Increase the mass so that the height of the person is going to be taking place. What about the number? Number yavtharagutandre, take the example of single celled organisms, amoeba. Amoeba nal nodabodu, you can take the example of amoeba. Amoeba single celled organism, okay. Now what will happen here? This single celled organism ninda, now whenever protoplasm increases, olagade cell increase aagutodangidre mass, protoplasm is going to be now increased, then what will happen? Division occurs. When the division occurs, then what will happen? Two daughter cells are going to be formed. Two daughter cells are going to be formed. Number of cells, number of individuals also increase. Number of individuals also increase, plus mass also increase. These are the twin characteristics of growth. So, increase the mass and the number. These are the twin characteristics of growth. So, here, in the one character, that is, increase the number and automatically, reproduction also. Reproduction and santana utpatti. Reproduction is also taking place. One amoeba and the inner amoeba bandu. How it is occurring? Because of growth. Amoeba height triangle, doddu hange. Adre divide. When it divide, automatically two daughter cells are formed. Andre, here it is considered as a reproduction. Reproduction, growth. Both here it is going to be applicable in the single celled organisms. Growth naagutade, simultaneously reproduction is also taking place. But here you can observe that the totally whatever we are observing, the twin characteristics of growth andre, increase the mass and the number. Right, this character is over. So how the growth is taking place in the living organisms? Growth is taking place in the living organism by means of cell division, or directly we have to say that cell division nalli eradu baruthe, mitosis and meiosis. But here we have to consider mitosis. Growth is taking place by means of mitosis. Where it is taking place, whether it takes place outside the body? No, inside the body. Growth is taking place inside the body. So this is growth is take cell division takes place inside the body. Hence growth agbekadre body olagade, inside the body it is supposed to be important. Now doddu high heels hakonde andre growth agandre growth alla, because inside multiplication of the cells which may takes place, or the mitosis which may takes place. Okay, so now these are the points you have to remember. First three points only. It is the irreversible permanent change of an organism. No change. Once the growth occurs, finish. Second one is growth normally existing as a twin character. One, though, increase the mass and the number. Third one is growth takes place in the living organism by means of mitosis. Where it is taking place? Inside the body. That one only we have to observe. Now these are the characteristics of living organism. Now we have to compare with the non-living things. In non-living things only, non-living object only, whether the growth is taking place, whether the growth takes place in the non-living things, that what we have to observe. Growth is taking place in the non-living things, how far it is applicable mass. In mass anne now criteria to undre, just we have to observe that. Increase the mass inside. But now in the non-living things, we have to observe that mass also increased outside. How it is possible? So growth also takes place in the non-living things. Growth also takes place in the non-living things. ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹೆಂಗಾಗ್ತದೆ, ನಾನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹೆಂಗಾಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ So, growth also takes place in the non-living things by means of accumulation of external factors. This is an important part here. Accumulation of external part and how it is taking place. This is the criteria of mass. Namatra hanga mass increase growth aagtade, that is inside. But now, outside also, accumulation of external factors. For example, mountains. Sand, mounds. So now, you can observe here, in the hilly region, how the mountains have been formed. Mountains hang formation agte, gudda hang formation agirthade, how the mountains has been formed andre, because of accumulation of external factors. That is the one thing. Sand mounds, in the desert area you can go. How the desert area, whenever wind occurs, sand particles have been accumulated at one region. So the growth occurs. Growth andre, normally accumulation of the external factors. Accumulation, that is internal accumulation, that is the living organism. External bandh, that is the non-living things. So growth not only takes place in the living organisms, growth also takes place in the non-living things. How the growth takes place in the non-living things? By accumulation of external factors. This is called as accretion. Anta word varthundi. Accretion andre accumulation of external factors. Sand dunes are there. Athwa sand mounds anta karadevano. Uskin gudda agirthade. Sand dunes, mountains, it is going to be taking place. Because of the accumulation of external factors, height of that is going to be taking place. That is also called as the growth in the non-living things. Suppose you made a dig of 2 to 3 feet. After 2 to 3 months you can observe, it is supposed to be covered. How it is going to be covered? Because of accumulation of external factors. So this is also considered as a growth. Hence, last what we are going to observe here, mitosis is not taking place. Remember this point. In the living organism, growth is taking place by means of mitosis. In the non-living things, growth takes place by means of accumulation of external factors. That only the difference we have to observe. So what we are going to observe, growth is, last word we have to observe, that growth is not a defining feature of, growth is not a defining feature of living organism. Growth is not a defining feature of living organisms. Andre living organism taste yakandre now character in kotevu, increase the mass and number. Here also increasing the mass. That is why growth is not only a feature of living organism, it is also a feature of non-living things. Hence, it is not a feature of or defining feature of living organism. In total, whatever they are going to be asked, you write the defining features of living organisms, you should not write the growth, because it is not a feature of living organisms. Followed? So, is erandu nenapidri, by means of mitosis, here by means of accumulation of external factors. For all these, the characters, whatever we have studied, illi mure character, irreversible permanent change of an organism and twin characteristics of growth, mass, increase the mass as well as the number. Ill number increase angle, here in the non-living things number is not going to be increased. Cell division, growth takes place in living organism by means of cell division. ಇಷ್ಟು ಮಾತ್ರ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೀಬೇಕು. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನ್ ತಗೋಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ, ಗ್ರೋತ್ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್, ಇಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನಾನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಕ್ರೀಷನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಫೀಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಫೀಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟಿಫೈ ಯುವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಫೀಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟಿಫೈ ಯುವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟಿಫೈ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ ಆ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಜಸ್ಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಬರೀಬೇಕು ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ನಾನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಬರೆದ್ರೆ ಮುಗೀತು ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಮಾರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ರೈಟ್ ಈವನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ವಿ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಎನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ different categories are there plants and animals so even the growth also takes place in the whenever we are taking two examples plants and animals in the case of plants growth takes place continuously whereas in case of animals growth is restricted after a certain age growth is supposed to be restricted that is the only difference what we have to observe among the living organisms ili now compare madadaga matra living and non living things both is normal that is cell division takes place but now among the living organisms only plants and animals in the compare madadaga growth is normally restricted in the animals but growth takes place continuously in the case of the plants andre continuous cell division is going to be taking place but nammatra hang aagangilla antandre in our also in living organisms animals nalli kuda cell division aagutade But certain age it is going to be restricted means it is going to be restricted only the injured part. Cells olagade damage agirutve repairing the last parts of the cells of the that is only normally doing the work. Cell division alle aagutade. Athwa injury whatever I told you that cut agirutade. Athwa body cells olagade damage agirutve antavella repair maada kelsa. That is what we are observing the mitosis. Mitosis functions already we have studied. ಮೈಟೋಸ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಆಗ್ತವೆ ಎನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಡ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ನೌ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಡ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಬೈ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ Understand the concept. That is the only thing. So now, number two, reproduction. Number two, reproduction. Reproduction. You know about this. All the organisms are having capacity to reproduce their own kind. You know that. So all the organisms are able to produce their own kind. ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜೀವಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಸಂತಾನೋತ್ಪತ್ತಿ ಕ್ರಿಯೆ ಜರುಗುತ್ತದೆ ಇದು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ನೋಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಆಲ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಓಕೆ ನೌ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ನೌ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ But mode of reproduction is different in different organisms that what we have to observe or study here. So now mode of reproduction or kind of reproduction. Right from any cell organisms we have to take. Single cell organisms only reproduction our ithyakade. For example, amoeba. In the case of amoeba, reproduction hang aagutade by means of binary fission. Binary fission. Sorry. Amoeba, binary fission. What you mean by term binary fission? Binary fission and the same pattern you can observe that this is an amoeba. Binary fission and the splitting. Yerada agudu. Binary fission and the splitting. When two daughter cells are formed that is considered as a binary fission with the single parent right so now next is amoeba nalle hydra nalli yav tara aagutade budding in the case of hydra we are observing budding itself. Budding means what? Budding andre, for example, this is the hydra. I am talking about the budding. Right, this is what we are observing regarding the hydra, hydra it is. So now number of tentacles are there in this is called this is the main parent hydra. When the main parent hydra matures, the small bud or the outgrowth is going to be formed at the basal part. This is called as a bud. So now I am repeating this one. This is the main parent hydra. You can observe after maturation, you can observe that a small outgrowth is going to be developed at the basal part of the hydra. This is what we are observing it as a bud. Even plant bud formation is going to be taking place. This is called as a bud. But the difference, you can observe that as and when it matures, this bud is going to be matured, detaches from the main parent and developed into independent hydra. Idon innondu hydra formation aagutha. Followed all of you. A small bud or the outgrowth which is going to be taking place at the basal part. So whenever it matures, yavaga mature aagutade, so automatically detaches from the main parent and develops into as independent one. ಇದು ಯಾವಾಗ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ಯೂರ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಬಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಅಮೀಬಾ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಹೈಡ್ರಾ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಈವನ್ ಫಂಗೈ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್. ಸಮ್ ಆರ್ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟಸ್ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಫಂಗೈ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ಫಂಗೈ ಶಿಲೀಂಧ್ರಗಳು ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. All these are the kinds of reproduction is considered as asexual reproduction. Reproduction alli erdu prakara irutha, sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. So binary fission, these are the examples what I am giving now. Hydra budding is there, fungi spores inda aagutade. So now these are the kinds of reproduction that is normally asexual part. Asexual part andre enu, single parent is involved for the sake of producing the young one. This is called as asexual reproduction. One parent, amoeba no aitu, hydra no aitu, spore formation is also going to be taking place. Followed. So even this is one more kind of reproduction we are going to observe here, that is amoeba hydra. So one more you can observe that the planaria anta baruthu. Note. Mode of reproduction, how it is to be taking place. In the case of planaria, you can observe that the fragmentation, this is also kind of asexual reproduction. Fragmentation is going to be taking place. How the fragmentation occurs, we can observe that the note. This is the planaria that what we are observing. Planaria. So now planaria is planaria antandre it is an invertebrate specimen. It comes under the platyhelminthes, flat worms, chappate hulugalalli bartha idu flat worms invertebrate, that is akashirikod. Illi enagutandre it is showing the remarkable power of regeneration. Remarkable power of regeneration antandre when we are supposed to be dividing the animal body into several pieces, each piece is developed into one more planaria. Note, this is one planaria, this is one planaria, this is one planaria. This is a mode of reproduction. So now andre when we are dividing the animal body, it is not possible to divide, take the animal and divide the animal body, but now accidentally the broken part is there, or sometimes fragmented part is there. So this fragmented part only grows into independent animal. This is called as normally reproduction. ಈಗ ರೀಜನರೇಷನ್ ಕೂಡ ಆಗ್ತವೆ. ಡೋಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ರೀಜನರೇಷನ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು? ಜನರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್, ಯಾವಾಗ ಕಳೆದು ಹೋಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಈಗ ಲಿಸಾರ್ಡ್ ಇದೆ, ಟೇಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲಿಸಾರ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ರೀಜನರೇಷನ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ. ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಟೇಲ್ ಕಟ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂದರೆ, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ರಿಮೂವ್, ಟೇಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ರಿಮೂವ್ಡ್ ಅಂದಾಗ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಟೇಲ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್, ನಾಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಲಿಸಾರ್ಡ್. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಲಿಸಾರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೋಡ್. ಲಿಸಾರ್ಡ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಿತ್ತು, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ಲಾನೇರಿಯಾ ಈಸ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಅಮೀಬಾ, ಹೈಡ್ರಾ, ಫಂಗೈ, ಪ್ಲಾನೇರಿ, ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ದ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಮಲ್ಟಿ ಸೆಲ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ಆಲ್ ಆರ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಎಲ್ಲ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಸಂತಾನೋತ್ಪತ್ತಿ ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ, ಆದರೆ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್. ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆ ಒಂದೇ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್. ನೌ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ಹೈಯರ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತು. ಸೊ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಯಿತು, ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟೂ ವೇಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಅಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್, ಆಲ್ ಲೋವರ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಹೈಯರ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ದಟ್? ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಬೋತ್ ದ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಯಂಗ್ ಒನ್. ಬೋತ್ ದ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಯಂಗ್ ಒನ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ರೈಟ್? ಈಗ ಹೈಯರ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್, ಎನಿ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ ಮೇಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಿಮೇಲ್ಸ್ ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಯಂಗ್ ಒನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್. ಹೈಯರ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಥರ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಬೇರೆ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಯಾವಾಗ ಎರಡು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಸತ್ತೋಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್, ದ ಲೋವರ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಟಿಬ್ರೇಟ್. ಬಟ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಕೇರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಟೇಕನ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ನೆನಪಿಡಬೇಕೇನಂದ್ರೆ, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ಡ್, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ 2 to 3 ಪ್ಲಾನೇರಿಯಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ರಶ್ ಇಟ್, ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಪ್ಲಾನೇರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಅಂದರೆ ನೋ ಆನ್ಸರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಎನಿಮಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ಡ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಒಂದು 5-6 ಪ್ಲಾನೇರಿಯಾ ತೊಗೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಕ್ರಶ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಎಷ್ಟಾಗ್ತದೆ? ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟಿ ಅನ್ನಬಾರ್ದು, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಮೈಟಾಸಿಸ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ರೈಟ್? ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಬಲ್ ಟು ರಿಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಯಂಗ್ ಒನ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಲೈಕ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್, ಅಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಎರಡು ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಇವೆ. 2 ಕೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್. ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು. ಸೊ ನಾವು